What's up, SaaS Masters? My name is George, and today I want to show you a really cool deal that's called SwipeBucket. If you guys want to jump to what the actual deal is and how it actually works, jump over to this minute. Now, what is SwipeBucket? SwipeBucket is a way to organize what you find on the web. Now, the first thing that you're thinking, if you have other tools, is that, hey, I already have something that takes screenshots. I already have something that takes notes. Take me, for example. I have Droppler and I love it. I have Nimbus and I love it. But this is different. I can't organize with those other tools. And this is what this one does. Now, rarely do I say that I recommend a deal highly. And this is one of those deals. I probably count these by my hand saying that this is a good deal. Why? Because it helps me organize. If organization is not something that you're looking for, then you can just skip on this deal. But if you're looking to organize what you find on the web, this is a really good deal. So let me show you what I'm talking about right now. Okay guys, this is the deal that's going on right now. It starts off at $59 for a lifetime deal. And basically that's all you need unless you need more team members and more storage. Let me show you what that plan actually gets you. For example, let me go into the highlights right here. You are tied to the big business features plan. On the first $59 plan, you get 10 teammates, which is more than enough for most of us, and 100 gigabytes of storage. Basically, I don't need more than that. I'm good with that. But if you need more teammates, more storage, or unlimited storage, jump into tier 3. Or if you want unlimited teammates and unlimited storage, jump to license tier 4. But if you're good to go with 59 bucks, trust me, it's worth it, because just having an organization of what you want to do, finding the internet, it's well worth it. Okay, what is it? Like I said before, it helps you organize. I'm going to show you some quick examples right here. So for example, if I go to my Facebook right here, for example, there's some post on my group. By the way, this is my group. You guys want to jump in there? Just go hit invite. All right. So if I hover over this post, there's this little icon that's from SwipeBucket. Now, one of the things I don't like about it is that you can't resize that icon. So in my personal opinion, I think it's big, but hey, it tells me that it's here. Now, if I click on it, the first thing that pops up with my Chrome extension is this right here. This is what makes things different from a screenshot taker, from a video taker. It's this. I just selected that post and I can select where do I want to put this. So for example, I created these buckets, but I can create a brand new one right now. In this case, I'll just put it in temporary and I can add tags to it. So I can say, you know what, this is from Facebook, and I could say this is for a deal. And it just adds those tags. Why? Because later on I can view those tags, or I can search via tags. Okay, I can add some notes here. So for example, this is an example for video, all right? And that's just a note for me. I'll swipe it and boom, that thing was saved. I can go view it, and that's what I'm gonna do right now. But basically what I did right now is that I know that it's in a specific folder where I can go back and actually find it. When I use Droppler, which I truly love, and I will keep using it because I will be telling you some downsides about SwipeBucket, is that organization. I can't organize on Droppler. I can't organize on the other type of screenshot takers, not even Nimbus Node, but this one does. Now I know that everything is in here. So for example, it just swiped who posted it. It's from Facebook, the message and the image from there. Here's my note. Here's the tags that I've added. Here's the date it was created. And if I update this, it will tell me when it was updated. I can move it to another bucket. I can delete it. I can duplicate it. And I can view the source link. So it actually grabbed that also. And if I need to edit this card, I'll just click on it right here. Here's the information. I can edit it. I can add some images, some links, just resize everything if I want. But that basically, I can do it right there. This was saved into my bucket. Now, that is the overview, all right, of what SwipeBucket does. Let's go jump into the actual SwipeBucket app. So this is the dashboard, right? And these are the three buckets that I've created. I will be creating more because the whole idea of this is to have organization and find what I need when I need it, right? And that's the idea. So I can create a brand new bucket just by clicking here, just name it. I can say new for video, all right? I can create a sub bucket if I want. I can view how many cards are here. I can share the bucket. I can add team members to the bucket so they can view those buckets. And that's the whole idea, organization. I can star these. So for example, I have some here in temporary. Here's the things I've taken. So for example, if I star this one, it will be here, right? So I can have a favorite section. I have a Kindle section. I don't use Kindle, but if you are a Kindle lover and use Kindle, then basically there's not much to think about. This is a good tool. Here's the tags. This is what I like about tags. These are the tags that I've created. And if I want to view anything that has to do with the Facebook tag, I click on it and it's gonna open it, all right? Anything that has that tag, it's gonna open it right here. There's cards with notes, all right? I can, what's shared with me, what I shared, recently swiped, and recently edited, all right? So you have all those options available. Now, if I go to, for example, Instagram, which are popular platforms. By the way, if you want to follow my wife, this is her Instagram. If I open this right here, again, I get that little swipe icon. If I get the swipe icon, I can save it. I can say IG, gotta go to temporary and swipe it. Boom, I know that's there, forget about it. I keep going, I watch what I want, and I can keep on saving, all right? If you guys want to follow me, this is my profile, all right, on Instagram. Go on over and follow me. On YouTube, if I'm on YouTube, here's the video that I'm viewing. Again, I got that little swipe bucket icon right there. I wish it was smaller. I wish like we can resize it. That's something I wish they had. Click on it, boom, grabs the video. I can say YouTube for tag, no notes, swipe it. Let's go view it. And in my swipe bucket, I can actually view the video. So here, I can click play and view it. Here's the information. I can edit that. I can add notes. I can add some tags to it here. I can delete it and I can have everything stored there. A lot of things that you can do. Now, what happens if you go to Wikipedia? If we have something like this, automatically this is highlighted. So if I highlight a text, I can save that text. So for example, I'll grab this right here, boom. And there's that little swipe bucket icon. Click on it and I can say text, swipe it. Let's just go view it so you know what I'm talking about. Okay, here's the text that I just grabbed. Now, what happens if there's a website that doesn't have those functions? For example, YouTube, Facebook, IG, and none of that. For example, I don't know, here we go. Here's this, there's no swipe option, but if I grab the text, I can grab it right here. But we also have the Chrome extension. What does that do? Well, if I click on the Chrome extension, we have several options available. We got the region screenshot, which obviously you grab a section and it just screenshots it. There's a full page screenshot, which will grab the whole thing. It's gonna screenshot it, boom, do it for us, and it's gonna save it. This is really good because, for example, I just bought this deal, SwipeBucket, and I wanna know what the deal terms were when I bought this deal because, you know, sometimes they come back, sometimes they don't, or sometimes I want to remember what was included. Oh, 100 gigabytes, I go check it out. So I can have, and something I will be doing is a what I've bought screenshot bucket. So for example, I'll just keep it on temporary right now, but I can say AppSumo, that's one of the ones, and bought, I don't know, something like that. Swipe it, and I have the whole swipe right there, right? Here's the whole image preview, it's gonna load. Obviously it's a big image. And we can share this if we like also. For example, we got email, link, I could just grab a link right here. Public link, grab that there, copy link, let's go incognito mode, send it out to someone, they're gonna open it up, they don't need to have an account, and they can view the whole screenshot right there, all right? They can register if they like and all of that. Now, there's no white label right now, there's no C name, no custom domain, so those are things that are missing right now. Now, in a nutshell, that's the main part. Another thing you can do is, for example, in my settings, we can have a reminder email. So for example, I want 5 notes every day sent out to my email. So I remember what I swiped that day and I'll get those emails if I want to have this function. Also for Kindle books, you have that option. There's an application for Android and iOS. What can you do with it? Well, basically you can view your swipes. That's one of the main reasons that's there. Let me just open it up. All right, there it is. Here's my buckets, there you go. And other things that we can do is, I can have the option to share it inside a bucket, and I did it here. For example, I took a screenshot of my phone, and I selected the folder where I wanted to share it, and here is that screenshot from the application on Android. So what I do is, I select an image, and I just click on share, and I select swipe bucket, and that's the way I send it in there. Now, That is the whole main part of SwipeBucket. What I said, main purpose of this is to have organization. That's not something that I have on other applications. Even though I have, for example, Nimbus Note, where I have my notes organized, I have to do everything manually. I have Dropler, where I take some screenshots and I have a link where I share that. But then again, everything's a whole mess there and I have to go and organize it. That's something I don't do because that's just too much time that I have to take. Now, downsides about SwipeBucket, what I don't like about it. First off, we don't have a video recorder. That's something I do have with another deal that takes screenshots and records video. Another drawback about this is that you don't get a quick link to share. Now, for example, if I use my Dropler, I'll screenshot this. Here's the screenshot I just took. I'll save and it copies the URL, right? I can send that URL really quickly and someone has it. That's something I wish they had and they don't have that right now. I hope they add that. Another thing I don't see right now is that you don't have customization, for example, to make it white label. If you share that link, well, it's obviously it says SwipeBucket. And that's something that I wish they had branding, custom domain, and something like that. But they don't have it. It's not mentioned in the deal terms. Let me show you really quickly. So none of that is mentioned right here. Hope it's something that will be, whoops, I selected that by mistake. I wish something that they had there. The other thing that I hate is the size of the icon. I mean, that's just way too big. I wish it was something smaller. Another drawback about this is that it might conflict later on with another extension that you might have installed. So for example, it might conflict with Grammarly if it has like a little icon right there and the two of them pop up. That can be something that might need to be turned off. Now, that's something that they don't have an option right here. So if we have an option right here to say, you know what, turn it off for this site, like specific link, turn it off the whole thing. I just want to use the extension. Those are the little things that I wish that they had. But overall, I think it's a great deal for $59 if your main priority is organization. I have to mention that if, because if that's something that you don't care, then you don't need this, all right? Because if you already have a screenshot taker, a video recorder, and you have some note-taking apps and all of that, and you don't mind about organization, and you can do it manually or you don't care, then you can just skip on this one. But if you want organization and you want to have teammates and have someone invite there and see the buckets and all that, then this is a fantastic deal. Like I said before, I think it's a great deal. And honestly, these are word for word what I said. When I tested this before the video, 10 minutes in testing, I'm like, shit, I really like this. Just like that. I mean, because that's something I really needed. I needed to organize. So basically, there you go, guys. That's a deal. $59 to start off. Basically, anyone will do with that deal unless they want unlimited teammates and unlimited storage. Then jump into license tier 4, which is $399. But $59, it's a sweet deal. Well, guys, I thank y'all for watching. And if you guys would like to support me, do consider using that link in the description. It's an affiliate link. If you use that link, you help me out to get deals, show you how they work. And if you guys are interested, well, it helps me out with a small commission. I thank you all for watching. My name is George, and this is SaaS Master. I'll see you guys later.